Hello and welcome to a new series on the channel. I present to you RimWorld with the Ideoligion DLC. Now, I have put a lot of thought into this series, and this will be my first attempt in actually recording RimWorld for this channel. This game has a survival building aspect that has captivated my imagination so much that I get that same satisfying feeling of surviving and thriving just like in Minecraft. But obviously, this is very different. In RimWorld, you don't actually take control of your colonists, but rather you manage and govern how they work and how they take care of daily tasks. This is a colony simulator geared to generate a story that is narrated by one of three AI storytellers. In vanilla, the goal is simple: build up resources while trying to survive, and eventually find a way to travel to another planet. This can be accomplished by either traveling long distances to a friendly AI to catch a ride, or to gain enough nobility, as described in the Royalty DLC, for a royal ascent, or you could just do the research yourself, build the ship, and get your people out of there right there in your base. With the Ideoligion DLC, there is another option, which is called the Arco Nexus event. I have not yet found a playthrough of someone actually accomplishing this ending, considering that this DLC came out less than a month ago. But from what I understand, with this particular ending, the goal is to collect 3 map fragments so that your colonists can locate and activate the Nexus and be able to ascend. However, in order to obtain a single map piece, you must sacrifice over 350,000, silver of your colony's net worth, and you lose everything except for 5 colonists, 5 pets, and 2 relics. You are then taken to a new world where you have to begin again with a new colony, and you'll need to do the research all over again. Basically, it's like a soft reboot, and you'll need to do this 3 times. Just thinking about that makes me wonder how someone would have the patience to go through all that. Obviously, I'm not going to even attempt that last ending, considering that I am still new to this game with only about 100 hours of gameplay under my belt. So, quick disclaimer, I am in no way an expert, and I can guarantee that somewhere along this series, I will be making stupid mistakes and pulling off some really, really dumb moves. So what are we doing here, and what am I planning? Well, RimWorld has a large collection of mods, and you guys know me, I do love a good modded game. Ever since the Ideoligion DLC came up, I came up with an idea to put together a mod collection where we would take a tribe of 5 people who have abandoned their old gods in light of a disaster where their home was destroyed by great blood machines sent by the gods. So, just think, everything you knew and everything you were taught to believe was proven all wrong. What do you do? This is the scenario that I've been brainstorming ever since the beta came out 2 weeks prior to the actual DLC release. So while the various mod authors took the time to update their projects, I sat back, experimented, and eventually fleshed out the idea that our tribals started to worship technology. They wanted to become as strong and as powerful as those great blood machines that had completely shattered their world, and they want to transcend their frail mortal form. They want to become transhuman. So let's go over the mod list that I've put together, and there's a section for framework mods, transhumanist mods, and vital mods. Now, the reason why I have taken one particular mod and labeled it as vital is because it is a mod that I needed to make a special mental note for, and it's called Tech Advancing. With the existing scenario, system in the game. It makes sense that playing as a tribal group, you will need to research new technology, but because you're starting from such a low level, you'll be advancing it very, very slowly. So, let's say that you want to research electricity. Normally, you would need about 1600 points in order to get it. However, as a tribal group, that value is doubled to 3200 points. In fact, just about everything that is industrial level and higher will take a tribal group twice as many points in order to finish those research projects. With the mod Tech Advancing, it will scale the cost requirements to research new technology, and if you meet certain requirements of a tech level, such as discovering more than 50% of research projects within a given level, let's say medieval. For this example, when your colony advances to the next level, which would be industrial, it will remove the point penalty needed to finish the projects for that level. Eventually, I want to work my way from Neolithic, since that's where we're going to start, to medieval, to industrial, and then to spacer, and finally be able to work on the high-end ultra research projects. Now that we got that list taken care of, I've also added another section where I organized my mods that I labeled as other tech. This is basically for my personal preference, like Dub's Bad Hygiene, Rimatheller, Renatomics, and other odds and ends. This section of the list actually has nothing to do with working towards a transhumanist goal. So if anyone wishes to use this mod collection and play along with the series, then feel free to add or modify this section of mods to match your personal taste. Okay, the next section of mods that I have grouped as quality of life improvements, because they alter on how a game functions, but they do not add new items or tech to the game. These mods work behind the scenes, so there are improvements on how your colonists can haul and carry things, or work on construction projects, or even how they build their furniture. And the last set of mods that I've listed, it's just a simple collection of UI mods where they don't alter on how the game functions whatsoever. They only present the data differently. And I am a personal fan of color-coded traits, little interaction bubbles that pop out when my dudes interact with the colonists, and a quick way of checking my pawn's inventory, just like if it was an RPG. Wow, that was a lot of material to go through, and that was just explaining my idea and the mod list that I put together. Okay, let's see if we can try and make this a little bit simple. So, for episode 1, it will be all about the setup, like setting up our game settings, our colonists, and all that fun stuff. And episode 2, which I will release at the same time as episode 1, will have the actual gameplay. So think of this as part 1, but if anyone wants to jump ahead and see the gameplay, go ahead and jump ahead to episode 2. And also, the mod collection, the link, will be in the description. And if anything changes throughout the course of this series, I do plan to stay on top of things and keep that mod collection updated. Okay, now let's go ahead and start the game by clicking on New Colony. And I already said that we were going to go for Lost Tribe. So we'll go ahead and hit next. I think under scenario or scenario editor, there's something we can do with it, but I'm not going to mess with it. And we're going to hit next. Now it's the AI storyteller, and I am only vaguely familiar with the concept of an AI storyteller. If you want the classic RimWorld experience, you would use Cassandra. If you want a laid back gameplay, then you would choose Phoebe. Or if you are a masochist, you go for Randy, who sometimes is nice and sometimes hits you hard. But me being the new player that I am, I'm going to stick with Cassandra until I get to know the AI storytellers a little bit better. And I'm going to go for Strive to Survive. This is for experienced players who want a rough story requiring skill to survive. All my other times, I've been practicing on Adventure Story. So I think it's time for me to bump myself up to a harder level. We're going for Reload Anytime mode. Next, we are going to choose our world. So I'm going to go ahead and turn on the Nudist Tribe, the Cannibal Tribe, and the Cannibal Pirate Gang. We have room for one more faction. So I'm going to choose a second Civil Outlander Union. And if we happen to choose one more, it says right here, gameplay problems can occur with more than 11 factions. Well, I honestly don't want to risk it, so we'll go ahead and do two Silver Outlander Union. So we'll have an extra faction who's willing to trade with us, you know, stay neutral. We're going to set this at about 50%. And the seed, I have not really set this in stone, but the one that seems to be working for me in all my practice runs is just simply Whisper, you know, my name. So we'll go ahead and generate a world and let that load for a second. Okay, so far I am used to playing on a temporal forest biome with year-round growing. At this point, I feel that that's too easy. So maybe we could try either a temperate forest or a tropical rainforest with at least 10 or 20 days out of the year where you can't grow crops. Something to just up the level for myself. So before I choose anything, I'm going to go to advanced and I'm going to choose, I'm going to choose this one, the 275 by 275 map size. I'm going to leave this on auto. Okay, now the factions, you will see that we have two Silver Outlander Unions and they will stay neutral to us. Okay, now this is going to be the fun part, choosing where to go. So give me a moment while I look around. I do know that there is a mod called Prepare Landing, but as of this time, it is not working with RimWorld 1.3. the Ideoligion DLC, so we have to search manually. But basically what I'm looking for is from small to large hills, granite and marble, and on a river. The rest we could just figure out as we go along, so give me a moment and I'm gonna try to choose my landing site as carefully and as thoughtfully as I can. Okay, I think I found something that I want to go with. It is a temperate forest, but it's within range of the Empire and a couple of factions which I could trade with. It has 40 out of 60 days of growing season, and it has granite, sandstone, and marble. Big thing is that it's on a river. It has some mountain cover, but not all, and there are no caves. So let's go ahead and look at the coordinates. It's 27.77 north and 54.66 west. So let's go ahead and move on to the next step. So we could obviously choose some pre-made Ideologions. Wow, that's an unusual word for me. But I am going to go for custom. So we're going to go ahead and create a custom Ideologion. Okay, from what I understand, abstract theists believes in an omnipotent god being, and they tend to be monotheistic. That's why there's a Christian origin and an Islamic origin. However, there's also an embodied theist where they believe that gods walk among mortals, but they're not mortals. And this, what I would imagine, lead to polytheism. So I guess that's why the Hindu origin is listed here. However, there are philosophies that don't really bother themselves with the concept of deities. Ideological, for example, is more agnostic. They acknowledge that there is a higher presence, but there's nothing to prove or disprove anything, so they just basically go with it, roll with it. And then an animist is people who believe in spirits, like spirits of the wind, spirits of anything. So, in my head, I'm thinking that our tribe were once believing in spirits. However, this next structure, the archivists, the tooltip says that they are the true gods. They know the mortal structure of the universe, and serving them is how we will connect with it. This is what I'm thinking, is that the tribe switched their structure to this. Also, there is also a thing for Buddhist origin. I'm actually not a philosophy student, so I actually don't know the difference between Buddhist, Hindu, Islamic, or Christian. But if it goes in this category, I guess I'll just roll with it. For now, we are going for the archivist. Now, we're going to choose our memes, things that mean a lot to us. First, transhumanist. That is the one that's required. Now, I'm thinking human primacy, high life, because, well, it's new. I want to play with it. And collectivist. So basically, we are having a very strong impact, but I'm using low and medium memes. I'm not even bothering with the high level memes right here. So let's go ahead and choose our precepts, symbols, and backstory. Okay, I really am digging what the game has generated for us. Tribal technologism. So would be the technologic and the technologist, and the ritual room would be shrine. You know what? I am going to just roll with it. So the aerotech or archotech mind showed us that superconsciousness is not a matter of sober, mechanical logic, but one of multi-mode thought. Technology allows humans to be more like the aerotechs. In the end, the aerotechs will depart when they find a people who present themselves as worthy partners to the machine god consciousness. So, I went ahead and looked through the precepts and added a few that had absolutely nothing to do with it, but I thought, you know, it'd be fun to play with. For example, the dark light. It is not required, but I added it anyway because I really do like the dark light mode, the lighting. So, a few things. Research is very fast. We definitely need it. Drug use, well, that's essential. Insect meat, I figured, you know what? Nom nom nom, let's enjoy that. And let's see, what other things? Work drive is tripled. Bonding, as much as I love my cat, and this is very much against my nature, well, we are not going to have any bonded animals. Cannibalism, well, I said acceptable, but it's basically a don't care. Apostostasy. Basically, if you lose faith in the religion and change, that is a no-no thing. So I put that in there. Let's see. Slavery acceptable, because I honestly have not decided whether or not to use slaves or whatever. So I just put it as acceptable but not required. And then spouses is one only. Clothing, no rules. Organ use acceptable. Scarification, I left it at the default, which was said that it was horrible. And moderate bigotry, I figured just to have a little bit of a group or herd mentality mindset would help, you know? Okay, so I went ahead and chose a couple roles. And you could tell from these names that I've taken inspiration from Mass Effect and Fallout. So, Clan Chief as the leader, and that's a Fallout, that's a Mass Effect reference. So is the Moral Guide as the consort. However, for the Fallout reference, the Production Specialist is the Overseer, and the Research Specialist is the Zealot. I was thinking Children of Adam. But basically, the specialists, they can do their job a way more efficient than an ordinary person, but it disables their ability to do other tasks like hauling or cleaning, so I gotta choose them carefully. Anyway, for rituals, I chose 4 calendar rituals about the 8th day of every month that they had. So, like December, Jugus, September, and December. Yeah, and I chose it on the 8th of all of those 4 months. And you either discover an ancient complex, or recharge your psi focus, or you get a random recruit. However, I did choose a smoke leaf circle that could be done at any time to recharge the psi focus. And I did name the funeral as Eulogy of Whispers because, well, I put a reference of my name in there, you know? Anyway, buildings, just put a few things that I thought sounded nice. Simplified the names of the relics, so we got a tablet that's just a codex, like their guide on how they live. The cipher and how to unlock the codex, and you need both of them to unlock the techno-arch. Now, this next part came as a last-minute decision. The weapons. We are going to start out with Neolithic weapons, but we want to discard them. We want nothing more to do with them. So, we are going to start with a major debuff of using Neolithic weapons, but eventually we're going to work our way to Ultratech. And then, venerated animals, technically, they don't make sense since there's no animal bonding, but I put down Thrombo because, well, if you don't bond with animals, then maybe you see one as a worthy adversary, worthy of respect, and to give it a wide berth. So, just a simple, you know, little flavor, I guess. I don't know. Okay, and then the hair and the tattoos, I kind of left as they were. Now, here's the fun part. I do have the Prepare Carefully mod, but I want to challenge myself. So, I'm going to go through and shuffle through these characters using random as I need, and then I'll bring you back so that when we get our 5 colonists that we want to keep, use the Prepare Carefully mod to make cosmetic changes like hair, body type, you know, little things like that, but nothing to really give an advantage. So we're technically just using what we can get from the randomized characters with a few cosmetic tweaks. So give me a moment, let me go through this. Okay, I think I got a good crew going, something that would work in my head. So we got someone who's going to be a warrior with some shooting, but slothful and nudist. I'm thinking about switching that out. However, we do have a logger who has a chemical interest, which does work, but 9 in plants. We could grow heal root right away. And good crafter, so this one is a keeper. The butcher, we got 11 in cooking. And also animals, so I guess they would take care of the animals. So that, I think, will do nicely. And also, we do have a dedicated healer with a healing score of 9. We also have a dedicated construction worker. So I think we need to go ahead and try again with this one person. see if we can get something in the intellectual and shooting department. So let's see if we can do a couple rerolls. Nope. Teetotaler. Nope. 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 All right, let me see if we can find someone. Okay, I think I got my fifth person, and she is the sister of the cook. So we'll go ahead and put these two together to remember that they're sisters. Let's see, any other relationships? Boar. Okay, it's just a brother. Okay. So let's go ahead and hit prepare carefully, and let's go ahead and tweak the cosmetics of this. So it looks like, let's go ahead and change your hair color. Yeah, let's go ahead and do a few little tweaks. Okay, I just used the prepared carefully to change the names and cosmetics of these colonists. So we got Whisper the Archer and her sister, Cookie the Butcher. We got Strider the Logger, who's also my top crafter, Zella, who's going to be my doctor, and Jonalyn, who's going to be my constructor and farmer. As for relationships, as it turned out, Whisper and Cookie are siblings, and Jonalyn has a brother out there in the world. For starting equipment, I just simply removed the three random pets and left everything else the same. So, the next step is to actually save our preset and get ready to start with the gameplay. So, I'm going to go ahead and end episode one here because this was all about the setup, the backstory, and behind the scenes with the mod list and everything. And with episode two, which is technically part two, will be our gameplay as we get started into the land. Hopefully everything works out, build shelter, and all that fun stuff. So I'm gonna wrap it up for the moment and get started on episode two. So until then, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.